Let's go!
All aboard!
All aboard!
Let's go!
All right.
I just thank him for it. He's building a church here, y'all.
Yeah.
He's building a family here.
Yes.
You know, and I'm so grateful that the ones that are here now, I can depend on.
Yeah.
See,
yeah.
He's putting people around me that I can call.
Yeah.
Amen. You know,
1 o'clock, 2 o'clock in the morning, they're gonna be there.
Yes.
When I got sick the other night, people checking on me. Y'all went to praying.
Yes.
See, they got their praying. Social media. Now everybody know. I don't even know. So y'all know. Everybody, people know about social media. Y'all don't know about that social media. That's new to me. You know. But hey, that's what we up with. That's what we got today.
Right.
You know, people gonna tell it. You know.
Right.
So let's make up in our mind that when people talk about us, they're going to talk about the goodness of God.
Amen.
When people see us, they're going to see the goodness of God.
Amen.
Man, I heard about some people down there at Last Call Ministry. Man, those people on fire.
Amen.
Some people believe everything in that book, they believe.
Amen.
Right? Some people walk by, they call it faith.
Amen.
Some people will step out with 50 cents and go to Houston with 50 cents.
Amen.
And got there. I heard they got there.
That's
he
right.
Have a 50 cent. He stepped out. He used his faith.
That's yeah. Right.
They call it faith.
Amen.
Because without faith, it's impossible to please God.
That's right.
Matter of fact, we ain't never seen God. How you going to believe? You talk about God, Jesus, you ain't never seen him. But by faith, we believe that he is.
Amen.
And that he's a rewarder of those that diligently seek him.
Amen.
He's gonna bless us, y'all.
Amen.
He's blessing us even today.
Right.
Come on, look at y'all life.
Right.
Look over your life.
Yep.
See how many times God was there with you. Look over your life. You know it wasn't nobody but God.
Amen.
Look back in the pages of your life.
Amen.
But nobody but God.
Amen.
But God.
Nobody.
If it had not been for God,
huh.
Where would I be?
Yeah.
Where would I be? Locked up in a penitentiary somewhere.
Amen.
Be dead because they killed me.
Amen.
Put a gun in my head, blow my brains out. I had
Amen.
A gun upside my head. One day he just didn't pull the trigger.
Amen.
He said, I'll blow your brains out.
Me
but
too.
God wouldn't
me
let
too.
It. God
right.
Wouldn't let it blow
Amen.
My brains
right.
Do it.
Because I had to come here
to
right. Right. Minister the word of God.
Amen.
I had to stand
Amen.
Before his people today.
Right.
And bless Amen. His holy name.
Amen.
Let's clap our hands. Sister, you got any announcements this morning?
Okay,
come on,
Lisa. Praise the Lord. Sister, our secretary, Sister Lisa.
Good morning.
What I want to do is, it's concerning our pride and
sickness. Okay.
Marshall Wade has
yeah.
been on my mind.
Yeah.
He's been on my mind, and I,
yeah. think no, what I want to do is to, we can get a flower or something.
Yeah.
And I want to go see Martha.
You do. Yeah, sir.
Okay.
You got it.
And I just wanted to run it by the family.
Yeah, you take it. Get what you need to go do what you got to do.
You know, because
this is the day they should go with you.
Yeah.
Okay. Because he's been on my mind here.
Whatever comes, you got to take it.
Matter of fact, I talked to Lord yesterday about
okay.
And he said we need to go and see him.
Okay.
Yeah. And I was
How would I know? How would I make her know?
Marshall.
I don't think she knows.
You wouldn't
know. I got a picture of my face.
You done seen him before.
Okay.
He's LaRaphlus. He's our first cousin. Real close. My mother was Tim.
Yeah.
My mother was his aunt.
Something going on with him?
Yeah, he had a stroke.
Yeah,
okay.
So, and I just want to run it by him.
Yeah, and
go and visit with him, go and see him. And another thing I want to do is, I got everybody's name and their birthday. Mm-hmm. But what I need is everybody's phone number. Just like, contact. You know, when pastor getting sick, you know, and having to cancel church, you know. I got people that, you know, I could call that I did get in touch with. Mm-hmm. But just in case, you know, something like that and neither one of them can, you know, call people, that would be my job. Right. I did get everybody's phone number after church today. But, you know, other than that, just keep everybody, you know, people that's on the prayer sick list.
Yes.
You know, just pray for everybody.
Okay.
Other than that, that's all I have.
All right. Can we add the girl's
great-grandmother,
May? Good job.
Yeah,
I heard about May.
Sister May?
Yeah, Sister May. She had a quadruple.
She did?
Yeah, someone told me that.
And you know, look how God works too, though. She had so much blockage, a main vein rerouted itself.
Isn't that something? Yeah.
They didn't even know how. Doctors didn't know how that even happened.
We'll
pray for her. We'll pray for her when the spirit starts moving. Remind us to pray for her. See, we're gonna get this thing. We gotta come on up, y'all. God has commanded us to come up high. God has commanded us to. We can do better.
Okay.
He's calling me. Us to do better now. Because like when I went down, it ain't supposed to stop.
Amen.
I trust all y'all in this in my house.
Amen.
This ain't supposed to stop, Brother Caldwell.
Amen.
You're supposed to step on up and come on with. See, that's why the things in your life you gotta get
right.
So you can go and see, cause you next month. You next month next to me.
Amen.
You been there with me. Huh? You been there with me. You the only one in that been there with me.
Amen.
See, that's why when I saw you at Slickwick thing that day. And God told me you was going to be with me. You with me, ain't you?
Amen.
Who is at the benefit of the big tree?
Yeah.
You with me, ain't you?
Yes, sir.
So God now is calling you to come up higher.
Yes.
Don't try to figure it out. He already got it worked out.
Yes.
I'm telling you in front of your brothers and sisters in Christ.
Yes.
You're supposed to, hey man, we pastors in the hospital, we still having church.
Amen.
I'm preaching today.
Amen.
I'm preaching today.
Amen.
We going to come on with it.
Right.
Come on with it. We got to step up.
Right.
Brother Zell, even though he's young, he got to get his word. He wrote them cans. He loves wrote them cans.
Right.
He eats, sleep, boo boo cans. That's what he say he do.
That's right.
He got to start eating that word, too.
Eating that word.
That word. See, all of us, it don't supposed to stop because I stop.
That's right.
Can't let it happen no more.
Right.
We ain't gonna let that happen no
Amen.
More. If my wife got to come on back, over, y'all know what to do.
Amen.
Deacon Haywood wasn't here today, but Deacon Haywood called me this morning. Pastor, I love you. I'm just checking on you. I ain't gonna be here today.
Amen.
I said, well, Brother Deacon Haywood, that's the first deacon.
He's
out of time, but I guarantee you I'll be there next week.
Amen.
I said, well, I ain't got no more deacons.
Amen.
You the only deacon I got.
Amen.
But thank you for calling me and letting me know.
Right.
See,
that's
see, Brother Haywood.
Right.
Some people call him dumb and stupid.
He's
not dumb and stupid.
No.
That boy got a heart for God.
Yeah,
one thing I know, he loves God.
He loves God.
Love but the world of college, the mother churches, they pushed him out.
Yeah.
They ain't have no room for him.
They
didn't have no room for him. And he said it right here. He said, at last thought, I feel loved.
Amen.
He said, I'm always making, because I ain't no better than him.
That's
Right.
Right.
Come on, man. Right. I'm gonna get a lot of teeth in my mouth. Amen. Reaching all over Africa and Australia, Canada. People see me. People, I got two men in Africa wanna be up under me. I ain't never seen them.
Amen.
Space communicate with them. Supposed to be going to Kenya next year and preach Holy Revival. Ain't been a now church up here. I ain't been a pope. I'll preach nowhere.
Amen.
Ain't called me to preach.
Come on. Even
the mighty man of God, the Texas Tornado, ain't never preached up there. Roland ain't never called. And Kevin went all over the world.
All over the world.
Operating. And you talking about operating in the anointing to call your name? When God come over and tell him, hey, your name is Jane Doe. Your name is Jane. Got it. Lay hands on you. Boom. He laid hands on me back in 1985 down in Freeport at Back to Revival Church. When he hit me, bam, I was on the floor. Then this thing, know he's standing on top of $1 prophet. And here I am.
Amen.
Here I am. He's heading on now. He's on. But ain't none of these churches around here. Let Calvin come right here and preach all the time.
All in his living room. Right. Sure
he humble himself for preaching in the living room.
Right.
Two men can't come in the living room.
No.
All these they got too much.
Yeah.
I'm listening. I worked for Dow for 50 years. Yeah. And I worked for Mr. Phillips. And I got Phillips. I'm an accountant. I'm this, I'm that. I'm a lawyer.
Yeah.
And come here and lower yourself. Humble yourself.
Humble yourself.
Come to a living room. But what they fail to realize, in this living room, we go all over the world.
Amen.
Stacy, y'all, the people know y'all all over the world.
Amen.
Prophet Dixon. They didn't know me. I don't even know you. Who you? I seen you on YouTube.
Amen.
Man, I prophesied about that storm. I don't know why God turned the storm, but he did. That was the storm meant to come here.
It was the
prayers of the righteous one availed much. Right. Must be some righteous people praying. That storm turned on up. Turn. Didn't come. But it tore up the Bahamas, didn't it?
It tore
the Bahamas all over.
It sure did.
And we ain't out of the woods yet. 2019 ain't over with. 2019 ain't over with. And I'm not going to preach, but I just had to. I want y'all to provoke y'all to start thinking. God using you, Brother Holmes, Brother Taylor, Jonathan. He using you. He waiting on me to commit.
Right.
To commit.
Amen. Right.
For God I live, and for God I die.
Amen.
You should be dead. You should be in the graveyard, man. You're supposed to be in the graveyard.
Amen.
But God, the grace of God, He allows you. He gives us time. Because He's depending on you. Somebody, you got to save them. I'm going to hell. There's somebody going to listen at you that ain't going to listen at me. There's somebody going to listen at you that ain't going to listen at Brother Carl.
Amen.
Only they got your name on.
That's right.
All over.
Right.
And only you going to minister to them.
That's right.
You going to be the light to them.
That's right.
If he did it, I can do it.
And right.
Follow you. They're going to follow you. They're going to follow you out. That's why God going to send you back. Clean you up.
Jesus.
And truly get your heart. Truly.
Yes.
Know who you are.
Right.
You are.
Got to know who you are. Once you know who you are,
you're
going to be the man of God that He called you.
That's right.
Ain't no devil in hell that'll turn you around.
Amen.
That's right.
That's what I'm doing. They talk about me. I don't care what they say about me. I know one thing. I ain't doing what I used to do.
Amen.
That's right, baby. Lord.
And I ain't where I need to be.
Amen.
That's right.
But I ain't who I used to be.
That's right.
By the grace of God. Only by the grace of God.
That's right.
Only by the grace. It's only by the grace of God, church.
Right.
He gives us grace.
Yes.
Yeah.
His grace is sufficient. And like Sister Christy preached, that was a powerful message.
Amen. Oh, amen.
And Sister Peggy prayed this morning. And she said, Lord, help us to forgive our own self.
Amen. Right.
You forgive us, Lord.
Help
us to forgive ourselves.
Right.
Don't beat yourself.
Don't beat yourself up.
See, sometimes I'm going to beat myself up. That's when I get frustrated.
That's, right.
That's when I allow to start cussing. You know, why am I cussing? Blessing and cursing can't come out the same mouth.
No.
Out the same river. You know, salt water and fresh water.
Right.
You know, salt water and fresh water can't run together.
Can't run together.
Huh? But hey, when you start looking at all the problems and the cares of this world, so much weight, you know, it weighs you down. That's why the devil always wants me to look back. That's why when he went down, who that? The angels went out to get Lot.
Right.
The angels told Lot, gave specific instruction. Whatever you do when they bring you out, don't look back.
Don't look back.
His wife looked back.
Right.
And she didn't make it.
She didn't make it either.
She didn't make it. She turned into a pillow of salt.
Sure did.
Because she didn't follow instructions. See, we got instructions, y'all.
That's right.
And we got to follow God's instructions.
Amen.
It's in this book. It's in that book.
It's in the book right
there. It's in that book right there.
Right.
He gave us specific instructions on what to do, how to live our life, how to conduct ourselves in the day on a daily basis.
Yeah.
Amen.
And then we're going to have victory, y'all.
That's
Is persecution going to come? Yeah,
yes.
Persecution going to come. Is hard times going to hit us?
Yes.
Sure, hard times going to hit us.
Right.
Boy, look at him. When they hit you and knock you down, well, he right there. He right there. He going to help us. All I got to do is reach up. Hey, here I am. Knock me flat on my face. And I reach up, he pulled me up.
Right back up.
He pulled me up. Then I run on a little further.
Amen.
I run on a little further. Let's clap our hands. Big God's brother, my wife has got a word. She had a word last week, but I got, you know, I fell down a little bit. And Stacey needs to come on, because we're coming on. Get ready.
All right.
Come on, Stacey.
And Brandon. We attended Trinity Praise and Worship in West Columbia. And, of course, upon arriving, I let them know that we were there to represent Last Call Ministries.
Beautiful.
So I went up, and the entire congregation prayed for Pastor, his family, and the church family.
How beautiful.
You know, when he was down.
Yes, yes.
And so the message that was given Sunday was, the best remedy when times get hard is to bless the Lord.
Mm.
Wow. And it was on my spirit, you know, to make sure Pastor knew that because of hard times.
Yes.
You know, when you're down,
yes,
you know that you make sure that in everything you give all praise to God.
Everything.
Not just when times are going good and your health is good,
take it
you know, but when your health is down.
That's right.
Because
that's
obviously.
Right.
During that time, he's like, I still need your attention.
It's
unfinished business.
That's right. That's
and I got to get your attention sometimes by taking you down so that he can lift you back up.
That's good.
So that was my praise report this
morning. Amen.
And you know what? He came that Sunday to see.
He told me he was.
He did.
And they made sure they both gave me their number because we had got there a little late and started at 11.
Yeah. And we'll keep him in prayer too that we're praying because he was sick yesterday.
He was down.
He was down. Come on, come back. He said, Mama, wait, get ready. I said, man, come on, I ain't going today.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, the devil was talking.
Yeah,
So he kept nagging at me. I said, man, come on, man. I said, I'll be ready to get him.
Okay.
You know, and the old story kind of came to mind. Get it right.
Get it right.
You know, sometimes you don't want to go. You gotta go.
So you gotta go. Yeah.
We don't want to. Sometimes when you don't want to be, you gotta be.
You gotta be.
That's
right.
Amen.
God was talking to me.
Yeah.
When he talked to me, through.
That's right.
That's right. That would hit me last night. Clean up until the morning, 3 o'clock in the morning, gotta be still working up. Come on, I got something to do. Don't tell Timmy, no, we got something we got to do with it. You know, when these God spoke to us, he said, you're going to start starting the fish. You're going to get on one side of us.
That's right. That's it.
Wow.
You know me.
I said, we're most stepping on this side.
I've
got to give me some grass trying to summertime. Got to make
ride
a strung a hole.
Yes, sir.
And get on the road the right way.
Get on the right way.
So, you know, I just want to say, you know, whatever you might be going through your mind, whatever the devil be trying to put on you, there's no word about it. Pray to God. Have trust in
faith.
Look, without faith, it's impossible.
Please, God. That's right.
Amen.
So, we're going to have that faith.
Amen.
You know, boy, y'all just don't know how to get there. But we go out there good the morning when we get up. We do say, get rid of them on the way. I said,
Amen. Let's stop out here.
Okay. So, turn it up. I want to hear.
I would like to say something.
Okay.
I've been honestly working with these couple of ladies.
Stand up, sister. Stand up.
I've been and honestly working with a couple of ladies that mm-hmm. down in the house where they don't belong. They yeah. feel like they don't, you know, they ain't got nothing, but they got that dope and that. Mm-hmm. It's the only people around for. Mm-hmm.
What song you want?
That's the song I want 16. It's going to play out, but I just love this song. Okay. And in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. And the earth was without form and void. And darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. You may be seated. Okay. There are many people, and I'm not, when I say many, I mean thousands of people who, I'm talking about born again believers now, who do not know or understand who the Holy Spirit is. And especially when it comes to the Holy Spirit role and functioning in the church. So this morning my subject is, who is the Holy Spirit? Who is the Holy Spirit?
Come on now.
Now, the Holy Spirit Church has always been here.
from the beginning of unlimited time. There has never been a time that the Holy Spirit did not exist. Because the Holy Spirit is God.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
But there is but one God. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And they are all three are called the Godhead. All
right.
Or you may hear the word Trinity, okay? Uh-huh. But God the Father, Jehovah, is the one who sent his Son, Jesus Christ.
Uh-huh.
And Jesus Christ is the one who sent the Holy Spirit, again, who himself is God.
Amen.
And but each with their own church distinct functioning. Right. I want to read Genesis 1 and 2 again. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. Mm-hmm. And the earth was without form and void.
Yeah.
And darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters.
All right.
So church, here we see the functioning of the Holy Spirit as he moved upon the face of the waters. And this signifies the beginning of life.
All right.
Because the Holy Spirit represents life.
Yes.
Now, God did not originally create the earth without form and void, okay? Because we know that everything that God created was good. Amen?
Amen. Right.
So this point, this happening, well, this point to a cataclysmic that took place after the earth, it affected the earth after God had created it. And so this took place that it changed the earth because many scholars said that when Lucifer revolted against God, this cataclysmic took place because he wanted to become God. And so when this happened, then everything was thrown out of, I just say thrown out of wax, okay? Right. That's what it's cataclysmic. It was chaos. And we don't know when God created the earth, but it happened some dateless period of time, but it did happen. And so when Lucifer revolted against God, then he was thrown out of heaven with one third of the angels thrown in the lot with him. Okay? And so now we see the execution of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is bringing the earth back in order to its habitable state that was created at the beginning.
Amen?
Amen. So every work, church, every work, and I mean every work that is carried out here on earth by the Godhead, mm-hmm. has been done through the person, the agency, the office of the Holy Spirit.
All
the
right.
work and the office of the Holy Spirit. Mm-hmm. He does the work here on earth.
Right.
Amen?
Amen?
He lives in us and he does the work here for us. Right. Because God sent his Son to do his job.
Mm.
And his job was to go to the cross to die for us.
Mm.
So now the Son is sitting in heaven right beside the Father at the right hand.
Amen.
So the Son said he will not leave us. He will not leave us comfortless. So he brought us the Holy Spirit to take control. So it's the power of the Holy Spirit that does the work. Amen.
Amen.
So even with Christ. Even with Christ, church, the Holy Spirit was involved in every capacity of his life. He was involved, even here, his ministry here on earth, he was involved in everything. He was involved in his birth, in his conception,
yes.
His birth, his death, his resurrection. Even to the finished work of the cross.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
In fact, Jesus did not die on the cross until the Holy Spirit told him exactly when to die. Amen. When to die. Everybody turn and look at Luke. Look at Luke chapter 23.
Luke.
Luke chapter 23. And we're going to look at verse 46. Luke chapter 23. First person to get that, say amen. I'm ready to start.
Amen.
Okay, I get two or three. Okay. Everybody ready?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Verse 46, and it reads, and when Jesus had cried with a loud voice. He said, Father, into your hands I commend my spirit. And having said thus, he gave up the ghost. And that's when the Holy Spirit told him exactly when to die, when he gave up the ghost. Amen? Because the Holy Spirit is called not only the Holy Spirit, but it's called the Holy Ghost. Amen?
Amen.
So again, Jesus did die until, like I said, until he was told that he could die. And I say that to point out this. No man took his life. No man took his life. He freely laid down his life for the whole world. And he had the power executed by the Holy Spirit to take it back up again. And he did just that as Amen. Our resurrected Savior Amen. To all who would believe. Amen?
Amen.
So I want everybody now to turn and look at John. We're going to do a lot of scriptures because I'm going to, you know, make everything plain.
St. John.
No, yeah, St. John, chapter 10. John chapter 10. I feel when I hear three amens, we're going to start.
Three amens.
Amen.
Come on. Okay. It reads, therefore does my Father love me, because I lay down my life that I might take it again. No man takes it from me.
What verse?
Oh, I'm sorry. Verses 17 to 18. Chapter 10. Well, I'll read that again.
Come on.
Okay. Therefore, right there?
Yeah.
Okay. Therefore does my Father love me, because I lay down my life that I might take it again. Verse 18.
Come on.
No man takes it from me, all right, but I lay it down myself. Mm-hmm. I have power to lay it down.
Mm.
I have power to take it again.
Amen.
This commandment Amen. Have I received of my Father.
Amen.
Amen. Right. So God the Father gave Christ the latitude to do what he desired. And his desire was to do the will of the Father. Amen?
Amen.
And so he voluntarily laid down his life for us. He didn't have to do it.
Amen.
He voluntarily laid it down for
Amen.
Us. John chapter 15, verse 13 said, greater love has no man than this, that a man lay down his life for All his right. friend.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen?
He called us his friend.
Yeah.
He called us his friend. How many of us can honestly say that we will lay down our life for a friend? You know, I do it in a heartbeat for my family, but let's be honest. Can you lay down your life for a friend?
Right.
That's what Jesus did for us. Amen?
Amen?
Amen? And because of that, church, I would not allow anyone or anything to take away my praise.
Amen.
To take away my praise Amen. And to take Amen. Away my worship.
Amen?
Amen? Because God has been too good. He's been to sin debt that hung over the head of all humanity.
Right.
He only came upon certain individuals like the prophets and the kings and the priests. And he only came upon them because God had called them for a certain assignment or a certain task when he came upon them. Then after that assignment was over, he would leave because the dispensation of grace had not been.
Amen.
And always, the moment one confessed their faith in Christ,
Hallelujah.
He takes up Christ that made it possible.
Amen.
For the Holy Spirit to come to this world in a total new dimension.
Amen.
And that's why the cross of Christ must be the foundation of one's faith. And the cross of Christ must forever be the foundation.
Just
on Sunday, but on Monday, on Tuesday, on Wednesday, on Thursday,
Amen.
On Friday, on Saturday, 365 days
Amen.
Of the year.
Yeah.
Amen.
Right.
He should be our anchor, the
yeah.
cross
Amen.
Of what
Amen.
Jesus Christ did. Amen.
Amen.
Now, he tells us also that if we're going to follow him,
uh-huh.
we must adopt and deny ourselves
That's
and
right.
pick up our cross and
yeah.
follow him.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, what he mean by that? By picking up your cross and following him, he's not talking about watching too much television or not to wear give up makeup or ladies can't wear pants. That's not what he's talking about.
No.
He's talking about depending on him.
Amen.
When you pick up your cross, you totally surrender your life to him.
Amen.
You trust in him.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah. Amen.
That's picking up your cross.
Yeah.
And in order for the Holy Spirit to assist us.
Right.
And that we can get total right. victory of our lives, that is a requirement.
That's it.
That is a That's requirement.
That's right.
Because without that, the Holy Spirit would not work outside the cross.
That's good.
He would
right.
not work outside the cross.
Right.
He only works inside the cross.
Come on,
that means your faith has Amen. To be anchored to the cross
to
of
the cross.
Christ.
Tied to the cross.
Scripture tells us in Romans chapter 8, verse 14, For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. So if you're led by the Holy Spirit, then you are the sons of God. Amen? So without the leading and without the operation of the Holy Spirit, and I'm talking about every capacity of our lives, nothing will be done for God without the Holy Spirit. Without the Holy Spirit. And anything that is of God must be conceived by the Holy Spirit, birthed by the Holy Spirit, inspired by the Holy Spirit, and carried out by the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Otherwise, it is the work of the flesh.
Right.
Work of the flesh. And nothing will God ever accept, nothing in the flesh.
That's right. Amen.
Nothing will he accept in the flesh. He said it in his word, he says, nothing good dwells in the flesh. Amen? Because this flesh, this stinky flesh, is going right back to the dust. Ashes to ashes. Dust to dust.
Going back.
That's right.
Where it came from.
I want you all to turn to Galatians.
Come on.
Chapter 5.
That's good.
Galatians chapter 5.
Come on, man.
Good teaching, Mama.
Galatians chapter 5, 24 to 25. And they who are Christ have crucified the flesh with their affections and lusts. So if we're in Christ, then we crucify our flesh. Amen? So that means that we keep our flesh under subjection. Amen? So that means that we keep our flesh under subjection, then that old man is dead. That old man is dead, and we're new creatures in Christ.
Come on.
Because 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17 says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. So we're in Christ, we're new. That old man is dead. We don't want to bring that old man back up or keep bringing that old man back up. He's dead. And this can only be done by one understanding the cross of Christ.
Come on.
That's the only way it can be done.
Amen.
And being baptized into his death. Amen?
Yeah.
Because I'm not talking about being baptized in water doesn't save anyone. You can go down with us and you come back up with us. Amen? This is a relationship. Yeah. And when you're baptized, you're not baptized in water, you're baptized into Christ.
Right.
You're baptized into him, to his death.
Amen.
And anything you crucify, you know, you're going to kill it. Amen?
Kill it.
You're going to kill it. So whatever you're doing, you got to kill that drinking.
Yeah.
You got to kill that fornication. You got to kill that adultery.
Yeah,
you got to kill that dependency on whatever dependency that you may be on. You got to kill it.
Kill
you got to kill that lying spirit.
Help
you got to kill that gossip.
Me, Jesus.
Whatever it is, we got to kill
me.
It.
Yeah. Help me, Jesus.
So we won't fulfill the lust of the flesh.
Yeah.
So we won't fulfill the lust of the flesh.
Amen.
Verse 25 reads, everybody look at 25.
Come on.
It reads, if we live in the spirit, let us also walk in the spirit.
Amen.
So if we live, if the Holy Spirit lives in us, we walk in the spirit.
Amen.
Because we're led by him. Amen. Again, it goes back, if you're the son of God, you're going to be led by the spirit.
That's right.
And this walk that Paul is speaking of, it refers to our lifestyle.
Amen.
This is what he's talking about.
Lifestyle.
That means we should be holy. Because the scripture tells us, he said, be ye holy. Because I am holy. Amen? So that means if we're in Christ, then he abides in us, right?
If
we're in him. Which means we're connected to the true vine. So who is the true vine?
My God.
God is the true vine.
Amen?
He's the true vine. So the scripture says in John chapter 15, verse 5, it says, I am the vine. The Father is the vine.
Right.
You are the branches. We are the branches. So we're connected to Christ. Amen. We're connected to him. So we get all our nutrients from him. We get all our minerals from him. Everything we need, all our self from him. Everything we need, we're getting it from Christ.
Amen.
And who abides in me and I in him, the same bear forth much fruit.
Much
fruit. Apart from me, he said, you can do nothing. We can't do nothing without him. We can't even bear fruit if we're not in him.
Amen.
That's why I say, we would know a tree by the fruit it bears. Amen.
Uh-oh.
If it's not bearing good fruit, it ain't bearing nothing. It's not representing Christ. It's just a tree that's, what you call it when they're not bearing anything?
Barren.
Yeah, just barren. That's what I wanted, that word. So again, we're nothing without Christ. But in him, his fruit of evidence are evidence in our life. Amen? So the Holy Spirit Church is the fruit. Amen. He is the fruit.
Amen.
And what are the fruits of the Spirit? They are love.
Joy.
They are love, joy, peace, long-suffering, goodness, gentleness. Let me finish saying them. Thank you. They are faithfulness, meekness, and temperance. So these are the attributes of Christ.
Yeah.
And this is what we should have these attributes in us.
Yeah.
This is the fruit that we should be bearing. We should look just like him.
Yeah.
Amen?
Yeah.
We should have love in our heart. We should have joy, full of his joy. We should have his peace. Long suffering, whatever we have to go through, and just persevere through it. I don't care what's coming in going on in our life. Persevere through it. Gentleness, kind to each other, being showing goodness toward one another, being faithful to the things of God, having that meekness spirit, humbling yourself, and temperate, controlling attitude.
Controlling
that
anger. Yeah.
So the Holy Spirit, he's the one sanctifies us.
Yes,
he can't sanctify himself.
Can't do
so
it.
He sanctifies us so that we can look Christ-like. The scripture tells us in 1 Thessalonians, y'all go there, I want you to go there. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 23. But many people think that you sanctify yourself. You can't sanctify yourself. So you can look more like Christ. We need help. We need help by the Holy Spirit. When you get to 1 Thessalonians, tell me you're ready.
Amen.
Okay. And it reads, 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 23 reads, and the very God of peace sanctifies you wholly.
Mm-hmm.
And I pray, God, your whole spirit and soul and body be preserved blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. So again, it's saying that he sanctifies us, our whole being, our whole, our spirit. He said our soul and our body. And he said he preserves us. Hope we be preserved blameless until Christ comes again. Mm. So we can stay in the anchor to the cross. Yeah. So we can stay in the and be connected to the vine. Amen. Because we can find ourselves getting out of the faith. Amen.
Amen.
Or we can leave out of the faith. And if we leave out of the faith, then he can't. The Holy Spirit can't do anything for us. And again, then he can't sanctify us. He can't sanctify us because we're left the foundation. We're left the cross of Christ.
That's good.
Amen.
That's good too.
Amen.
Good, Mama.
Now, when I was a child, I would hear people talk about, well, really in my family, those sanctified people. They call them sanctified people.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know? And, yeah, and like the sanctified people make a lot of noise, you know, in the church and everything. And
yeah.
I'm like, well, I grew up in the Methodist church, so I feel like that was just their religion, you know, sanctified, you know?
Right.
And but because the church that I grew up in, the Methodist, you know,
dead church.
You know, we didn't praise the Lord. I mean, praise the Lord was like something foreigners to us, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
But when I did find out later in life, you better be sanctified.
Amen.
When you're set apart, when you're set apart for Christ, he sanctifies you. Amen. Because it's a relationship,
amen.
Not a religion. It's
amen.
A relationship.
Amen.
Amen. And so,
amen.
When it's a relationship, you can't help but to praise it.
Amen.
Amen. You can't help but to praise
amen.
It.
Amen.
So I thank God for progression sanctification. Amen.
Amen.
Because what the Holy Spirit does, he takes things out of us that means us no good. And what he does then, he places things in us so that we can grow up find Christ. And he keeps taking in, taking out, taking in, taking out.
Amen.
So we can look Christ-like. When I look at you, I say, something, there's something about you. Man, I see the brightness of you.
Yeah.
You've been with the Lord.
Yeah,
amen.
You've been with the, all over
hallelujah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's what and he'll be doing that for us until we go into glory.
Amen.
This is a lifetime journey.
Lifetime.
And he'll be taking things out,
amen.
Putting things in.
Amen.
So that means no one's perfect but him. But we have the Holy Spirit to assist us.
Amen.
Thank God for the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank God for the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Now, the Holy Spirit Church, he is the most important person here on earth, than anyone that you love. He's the most important person, but he's been treated down in the church age as if he does not even exist.
Right.
As if he does not even exist, and he's the one that's doing the power here on earth.
Yeah.
Now, when I wake up in the morning, the first thing I do I greet the Godhead. The first thing I do, I say, good morning, Father, and I throw a holy kiss. I say, good morning, Jesus, I throw a holy kiss. I say, good morning, precious Holy Spirit, and I throw a holy kiss. And I do this because I know I have enough sense. I didn't wake myself up.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying?
Come on,
and I have enough sense to know that I got to give gratitude. Yeah, I got to give gratitude to the Godhead. Right.
Yeah,
amen?
Yeah,
and I have to greet them with a holy kiss. Amen.
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 Hallelujah. That's good.
Let's look at John. Everybody turn to John. John chapter 16. Right. John chapter 16.
Amen. Good teaching.
And verses 13 and 14. John chapter 16, verses 13 and 14. When you get there, please say,
amen.
Amen.
Amen. Okay, verse 13 reads, howbeit, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth. So the Holy Spirit is called the Spirit of truth, who guides believers into all truth. Now, on the day of Pentecost, that's what he came to do. He came to guide us into all truth. And as I had mentioned earlier to you all, remember he only came upon individuals who have been called for a certain task? Well, now what he does, remember I said that didn't he have to leave? Well, now, like I said, we know I talked about it and you heard that he comes and he lives inside of us. So that means now he will never leave us, he'll never forsake us, he'll be with us to the end of the world. To
Amen.
The end of the world. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. So let's look at verse 13. Let's continue. It said, for he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he hear, that shall he speak, and he will show you things to come. So he does not speak of himself, but he only represents Jesus Christ. Amen? That's who he represents.
Amen.
But he proclaims to us, the church, the finished work of the cross.
Yes.
That's what he proclaims to us. And the reason why he does that is because it is the cross of Christ that gives the Holy Spirit the legal right to do all that he does. The legal right and the legal means to do all that he does for us.
Amen.
It is the cross of Christ. Because it's
at the cross.
So everything goes back to the cross. Everything goes back to the cross. And the Holy Spirit makes the benefits of the cross known to us.
Amen?
Now, and there's so much more benefits that we have in the cross. So we're only right now, we only have the first installment, the first down payment of the Holy Spirit as the center of everything because of the cross. And we'll get to everything else when we go to glory.
Amen.
But some of the benefits are, He forgives all of our iniquities. He heals all of our diseases. He redeems our life from destruction. He crowns us every morning with his loving kindness and tender mercy.
Yeah.
These
yeah.
are benefits.
Benefit.
He satisfies us. He satisfies our mouth with good things so that our youth is renewed as an eagle.
Yeah.
Amen?
Yeah. Amen.
And as far as the east is from the west, he has removed our transgression from us.
Yeah.
That is when you're in Christ. You don't get these benefits if you're not in him.
Yeah.
Only if you're in him. Amen.
Amen.
If you're in him.
That's good.
Amen.
That's good.
And like I say, the Holy Spirit only worked in the perimeter of the cross.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, during Christ's ministry of 3.5 years, now, you remember he had this disciple that walked with him, okay? There were 12 of them.
Uh-huh.
Now, he did not address to the disciples concerning the Holy Spirit, not until the end of his ministry. And I'm going to tell you two reasons why. One reason, because Christ was with them.
Uh-huh.
So he provided all that they needed, okay?
Man.
Because he was with them, okay?
Right.
And the second reason he did not give them any teaching on the Holy Spirit is because they would not have understood. Because the time had not yet come. Because when Jesus would talk to them, they always thought he was talking about a political kingdom. But he was talking about the kingdom of God.
Mm-hmm.
Amen?
Man.
But they didn't understand.
They didn't understand.
So now that Christ was about to ascend and to go and be with the Father in heaven, he informed them that he was sent another comforter.
Amen.
Right.
And the word for comforter is paroxletos. I'm going to say that again.
Amen.
Paroxletos. That is the word for comforter, meaning one call to the side of another to help. I'm going to say that again. One called on the side to another to help. So the Holy Spirit is called to help us. Amen? To always be with us. He's called on the side and another to help. When Jesus ascended, he left the Holy Spirit.
Amen?
So he did not leave us comfortless. Thank God we're not left alone, church. Thank God. Now, if Jesus had stayed here on earth, I want y'all to listen real good. If Jesus had stayed here on earth, his physical presence would have limited the spread of the gospel. You hear me?
Yeah.
Because he could not, because as an incarnation, because, well, I'm going to tell you why. Because as an incarnation man, he was a man.
Right.
He only could be in one place at one time. That's it.
That's it.
Even though he was 100% God and 100% man. Philippians chapter 2 verse 7 said, but made of himself no reputation, took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men. So he came, Jesus, God, came as in the form of a servant. He came to serve us. He came to serve us in the likeness of men. He made himself in the likeness of men so that he can go to the cross for all humanity.
Amen.
So he can go to the cross for, so he can save all humanity for those who will believe and receive the God's Son as their Lord and Savior.
Amen.
Now, we the church, we have been commissioned to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Right.
If we don't, it's called a sin. It's a sin. It's called the sin of commission. Mark chapter 16 verse 5 says, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature, baptizing them in the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost. Amen? In the name of the Holy Ghost. Now, when it says go into all the nations, we know we're all not going to all the nation, but your nation is right here. Yes. Your nation is in your backyard. Your nation is when you go to the grocery store. Right. Your nation is on your job. Spread the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Your nation is on the streets.
Let your light shine.
Your nation is wherever you can witness to others about the gospel of Jesus Christ. That is your nation. Amen?
Amen.
Amen? Amen.
Yes, sir.
That's your nation.
Amen. Amen.
The scripture tells us in Matthew chapter 10, turn up please. Matthew chapter 10, verses 32
to
33.
Matthew chapter
10,
verses
32
to
33.
Amen. Good teaching, Mama. Amen. Amen. You there, Christy?
Amen.
Okay. Verse 32 says, whosoever therefore shall confess me before men, him will I confess also before my Father, which is in heaven. Verse 33 says, but whosoever shall deny me before men, him will I also deny before my Father, which is in heaven. So if we deny Christ, and we can't witness and share the gospel of Jesus Christ and deny Christ before men, he said he will not confess us before the Father. He will deny us before the Father. Amen? He will deny us. So, church, we cannot be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, but it's the power of God unto salvation to all who will believe. To all who will believe. And not only that, our light should always be shining. Always be shining. But the church light right now is so dim. It is so dim. You can't tell us apart from the world. Can't tell us apart from the world. I remember about 3 years ago, we were at this benefit, and Stacy and I and my husband, and I remember that we were parked, and my husband got out to engage, and Stacy and I sat in the car. We was planning on getting out, but then I saw these three Christian women that I knew, and they didn't know I was looking. You know, I'm in the car, you know, and I saw them go to their vehicle trunk. And a trunk of their car.
Pop the trunk.
And took out a big bottle of liquor. Mm-hmm. I said, I know what they're doing.
Right.
And they had their glass and they was just pouring it, you know, pouring their glass. They were drinking their liquor. Now, am I condemning these women?
No.
But am I telling the truth? Yes. Because the truth will make you free. Amen?
Yeah. Yeah.
Because
yeah.
You know what? Because their blood is on someone else's hand. And I got to preach on sin. Because that blood will be on my hand. That blood will be on my husband's hand. We have to tell the truth.
That's
amen?
Right.
And that would set someone free. Amen?
That's right. That's right.
Now, how can we glorify God if we act like the world? Uh-huh. If we talk like the world? If we do the same thing that the world loves to do?
Right.
No, we can't glorify God that way. That means when our light is, we put our light out.
Yeah.
And others look, and God said in his word, he said, the least you do to my little ones, you do it to me. Because the other ones, the little ones are looking.
They said, I thought she was a Christian. You know, I thought he was a Christian.
Yeah.
You know, they don't want no part of Jesus then because they see that you ain't got what you said you got.
Right.
So we can't, we gotta let our light shine.
Amen.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 16 said, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify God the Father, which is in heaven. So our light has to be shining. Amen?
Amen.
All the time. Not just part time. You gotta be shining all the time. And again, we're not by ourselves.
Amen.
We have the Holy Spirit
to help us.
Amen.
Time of thee.
Let's look at Acts chapter 1. Acts chapter 1.
Acts
chapter 1, verses 4 and 5. Acts chapter 1, verses 4 and
5.
This thing's not hard. We make it hard.
Amen.
Jesus already did the hard part when he went to the cross.
Oh, my
you know, we got the easy way.
My God.
We got the easy way. And then got that comforter. And then assembled together with them. So Jesus is here with his disciples, okay? They assembled together. He commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which said, you have heard of me. Verse 5. For John truly baptized with water, but you shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit, not many days hence. So Jesus Christ, having addressed it, the Holy Spirit to the disciples, that's what he's doing now, just before his ascension. Now, he could have dealt with them about many things concerning the church, but the truth is he chose to address the subject that was most important, the baptism of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Without the baptism of the Holy Spirit, church, one cannot really know God as they should.
Amen.
Not as they should. Now, does that stop one from being saved? No. It's just that you cannot know God as you should.
Amen?
Amen. Because what it does, it limits your power to witness for the Lord.
Mm.
Because that's what it does. It limits your power to witness. I'm going to show you that. Look at Acts chapter 1, verse 8. Turn to Acts chapter 1, verse 8. Acts chapter 1, verse 8.
Okay, I'm going to read it.
Okay, it's verse 8 says, but you shall receive power after that the Holy Spirit is come upon you, and you shall be witness unto me, both in Jerusalem and in Judea, and in Samaria, and into the uttermost part of the earth. So this is what Jesus was saying to his disciples. He was saying to them, don't go and try to build churches. Don't go and try to witness to anyone. Don't go and try to do anything for me. Not until you are first baptized with the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
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 Amen. Because the Lord did not suggest to them that they needed the Holy Spirit. He commanded to them that they needed the Holy Spirit to carry out his work.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And nothing has changed, church, from then until now. It is still the same. It is still the same at this very hour.
Amen.
Let's look at Acts chapter 2. Acts chapter 2. We're almost done. Acts chapter 2. Verses 16 and 17. And then we're going to drop down to Acts chapter 39, okay? But still the same chapter. Chapter 2. When y'all get there, say amen.
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 Okay, verse 16 read, but this is that which was spoken by the prophet Joel. Verse 17, and it shall come to pass in the last days, said God, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh.
Amen.
And that happened on the day of Pentecost.
Mm-hmm.
And it still happened this very hour. He's still pouring out his spirit upon all flesh.
Amen.
Verse 39, drop down to 39. It says, for the promise is unto you and to your children and to all who are far off, even as many as the Lord our God shall call. So this promise, saint, is to your children and to all who are afar off. Meaning that this outpouring, as I just said, did not stop on their Pentecost, but continues on this very hour. Even as many of the Lord our God shall call. And that call is, whosoever will, let him come and take the water of life free. Amen?
Amen?
And so I say this to you who are around the world. Today is the day of salvation. The word of God tells us, whoever will, let him come and take of the water of life freely. Jesus is the door. He is the door, my friend.
friend. And let me tell you, he would never close that door. He said, come. And he's asking you to come today. I beg you to come and receive him into your heart as your Lord and Savior. Amen? So if you would like to say this sinner's prayer with me, this very day, you can be born again. Amen?
Amen.
So we're all going to say it together, okay?
Amen.
The congregation here at Last Call Ministry, we're going to say the sinner's prayer along with you all. So just repeat after me. And let me say one other thing. Once you receive Jesus into your heart, it's just that simple, my friend.
Amen.
There's nothing hard about receiving Jesus. So make this your day.
Amen.
For the rest of your life to serve
Jesus.
The cross.
Thank you for the cross.
I come to you today.
As a lost sinner.
Asking you to forgive me of all of my sins. And to cleanse me of all unrighteousness. I realize in my heart.
That I need a Savior.
Come into my heart this day, Jesus. And be my Lord and Savior. I have called upon your name, Jesus. And I believe right now. That I am saved. In Jesus' name. I pray.
Amen.
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 Wow. Hallelujah. Keep it up. Amen. Now, if you said that prayer, my friends, wow. Do you know when one soul gets saved, all the angels in heaven are rejoicing.
Amen.
And we here at Last Call Ministry, we are rejoicing with you.
Glory.
Yeah.
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 My friend, find your good church. A Bible feeding church that would feed you the word of God.
Amen.
Amen? So get to a church that will teach you everything that you need to know.
Amen.
Because the Holy Spirit is your teacher.
Right.
So again, we are so elated to have celebrated with you as a new believer in Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Holy.
Awesome.
Goodness.
People say anything nowadays.
Yeah.
You hear, say, I'm this, I'm prophet this, I'm bishop. Hey, if it ain't in that word, don't listen at that. Because the devil know the truth.
Amen.
But he gonna twist it. He know the Bible, but he gonna use it out of context.
Right.
He know it. From Genesis to Revelation.
Amen.
So we gotta know our word. We gotta study to show ourselves approved. Workmen that need not be ashamed. But we can be right for the Bible, the word of truth. It's hard to let somebody lie to you when you know the truth. Now, everybody's going to step down. He's going to lie. He's going to tell a lie. But you know the truth.
Amen.
You know what happened.
Amen.
But he's going to lie about it. He's going to lie about it. You stand there long enough and listen to him, you might start believing a lie. Because he's going to keep lying.
Amen.
So I just admonish y'all today to come to Jesus while there's time. Because no one knows day or the hour that we have to check out.
Right.
We're going to leave here, y'all. But when we leave here, I want y'all to leave here the right way.
Amen.
I want y'all to leave here in Christ. I want to leave here in Christ. I want to hold on to my salvation.
Amen.
With fear and with trembling. I got to work it out every day, y'all. Like Minister Johnny could say when he got up this morning. The devil told him, lay down. Don't get up. But the man of God, Minister Caldwell, kept showing love. Love is the key, y'all.
Amen.
Say, no, I'm not going to let you lay there. I love you enough that I'm still coming down there.
Yeah.
I'm coming there. If you don't even come out the house, I'm still going to come down there. That's what love does.
Yeah.
Love will go the extra mile.
Yeah.
Love.
Amen.
Love looks beyond the faults.
Right.
And it still meets the need.
Right.
See, love don't criticize and point your finger. You ain't gonna never be that. I ain't gonna even fool with you.
No.
I'm gonna ask God to give me the strength to fool with you.
Because
I know you messed up.
Because
I was messed up.
That's right.
I gotta look at my life. I gotta look at the chapter. Turn back some of the chapters in my life and look ahead.
That's
you right there, Dixon.
Yeah.
You was messed up.
Right.
You was a wretch. You were undone.
Right.
But somebody, somebody, Mother Johnny, showed you the Mother Hall.
Right.
Showed you the Leroy and Mama. That you get up and preach.
All.
And then next day, that evening, you at the crack house. But she still let you got up and preach.
Right.
Now look at me now. Look at me now. That's what love. She is all over to be with the Father. Sister Johnny, Mother Hall, we got to pray for her. She's bleeding in her body. They don't know where the blood coming from.
Yes.
You know. But we're going to pray that God give us a few more days.
Amen.
These women, these saints, pray for me, y'all.
That's right.
And that's why we got to pray, love, pray and show love to other people.
That's right.
Because that's the only reason why God spared us. He gave us time. Get it right. Y'all, I just want to encourage y'all. Let's clap our hands for that message that my wife brought. Those that need prayer, first of all, we're going to pray for this. Everybody standing to their feet. Everybody standing to their feet. Everybody standing to their feet. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Help me, Holy Ghost.
Yes,
Holy Spirit, have your way. Yes, in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. We pray right now for Brother Akbar in Pakistan, from Pakistan.
Yes,
one of the guys, one of the men that are listening at us on YouTube.
Yes.
We stretch our hands right now toward Brother
Lord.
Akbar. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come praying for our brother, our precious brother in Pakistan.
Yes.
Lord, a Muslim country. Lord, it's 80%, 90% Muslim, Father God.
Yes.
Father God, the unbelieving spirit, that lying spirit that says that Jesus is just a normal man.
Yes.
No,
yes,
Jesus is the Son of God.
Yes,
Jesus, you are King.
Yes.
You are Lord, and you are operating in the anointing of your Holy Spirit right now.
Lord.
You're operating in the third person of the Godhead right now.
Yes.
The Holy Spirit is here on earth right now.
Thank you.
Moving amongst the people. Father, I pray for Brother Akbar's spirit right now. Brother Akbar, I pray for his spirit right now. I pray for his protection right now. Lord, guard his household right now. Put a hedge of protection around him right now. Lord, I ask that a hedge of protection be put around him and his family, Lord God. Father God, and I pray that your word will come alive in his heart, Father God. And Lord, you'll give him a boldness, Lord God. Lord, you also give him wisdom. So when he declares your word, Father, to the unbeliever, Father God, there'll be something different about it, Lord God.
Yes,
and Lord, everyone that you have on his list to touch, Lord, I pray right now that they will come to receive the word that he has for them. Let the word that he has for them prick their heart, Father God. Father God, and draw everyone, Father, those unbelievers, Lord, that he's called to him, Father. And give him favor amongst them, Father.
Yes,
give him supernatural favor. And give him divine wisdom.
Yes, Jesus.
Lord, we pray for his strength right now. We pray for Brother Akbar's strength. Akbar's strength in you. Father, bless him. Bless his household. Make everything he puts his hands to do. Make it prosper, Father. In the name of Jesus. Father, Satan, I cut you off right now. In the realms of the spirit. Satan, I plead the blood of Jesus against you. Right now. In the realms of the spirit. Lord, I ask that your blood will cover him right now. From the crown of his head to the soles of his feet. Father, and every inward part of his body be whole and complete in you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. And I pray, Lord God, that all in Pakistan will be saved.
Yes.
All in Pakistan will come to the knowledge of the cross of Jesus Christ.
Yes,
I pray for that nation right now. Up in the name of Jesus. Lord, in Jesus' name, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Lord, you see him laying down, polluted in his own blood, Father God. You see him laying on his sick bed, Father God. Heal him, Lord. Raise him up. Strengthen back the right side of his body,
Lord.
The left side. Ain't this the left side? The left side. Strengthen the left side of his body. Right now. I speak to his legs.
Yes,
I speak to his arms.
Yes,
I speak to his lower extremities, Lord God.
Yes.
I speak healing right now back into this body.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let your virtue flow even now. Stretch your hands toward Missouri. Everybody stretch their hands toward Missouri.
Yes,
right now, Lord. I see your word.
Yes,
heal, touch, and set free right now.
Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes,
in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus. One that labored in the community, Lord God. One that moaned and travailed in the spirit, yes, Lord God. Yes, Father, for my soul and yes, the souls of many, Lord, yes, in this area, Lord God. Lord, she needs you right now, Father,
yes,
God.
Yes, Lord.
Mother Hall is sick, Father God.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, she's also sick by her twin, Lord. Yes. Her child, Lord God. Kevin, Lord God. Lord, she's bereaved, Father God. Father God, I pray, Lord God, that you would put her in the palm of your hand,
yes,
right now,
yes,
Father,
yes,
God.
Huh?
Raise her up right now,
yes,
Lord.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Comfort her right now, Lord,
yes,
in this time of need.
Yes.
Lord, I speak healing to her body right now.
Yes.
Huh? I speak healing to her mind,
yes,
right now.
Lord.
Comfort, yes, to her mind. Peace in this,
yes,
situation.
Yes.
I speak to the storm that's going,
yes,
on in her life right,
yes,
now.
Yes.
Lord, I command this storm to cease right now.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Father,
let your fire fall. Baptize her right now,
yes,
with your holy fire, Lord God. Lord, thank you for strengthening her body right,
yes,
now.
Lord.
Thank you, Lord God, for comforting her right now.
Yes.
Thank you right now,
yes,
Lord.
Lord.
In the name of Jesus,
name
we pray.
Jesus.
Amen. And amen.
Amen.
And overhaul.
We're going to pray for all of those on the prayer list. We'll pray for all of those on the prayer list.
We'll get the prayer list. We'll
everybody on the prayer list, get the book. Get the book.
We'll
if they ain't on the book, they're going to be in the book.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. They're going to put their name in the book. We'll just pray for everybody in the book. The Holy Spirit knows. Everybody,
yes,
stretch your hand toward,
yes,
this book.
Yes.
Father,
yes,
God, everybody's name that's written,
yes,
in this book,
yes,
Father,
yes,
that's,
Lord,
laying,
Lord,
in the sick bed right,
yes,
now, Father,
Lord,
God. I pray that you would raise them up for your glory.
Right,
God.
Yeah,
Lord,
yes,
continue to use them, Father God.
Yes.
Let this be a testimony,
yes,
of your,
yes,
healing power,
yes,
and your healing,
yes,
virtue, Father God.
Yes.
Father God,
yes,
you sent your word and healed them, Father,
yes,
God.
Lord.
I pray right now for healing,
yes,
in these bodies.
Yes.
Lord, everybody that's name that's written in this book, Father God,
yes, Lord,
touch and heal,
right,
today.
Now.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. And let the blood of Jesus cover them from the crown,
yes,
of their heads to the soles of their feet.
Yes,
and every,
Lord,
inward part of their body,
yes,
be whole and complete. In you, Lord Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
We prophesied about a storm that was supposed to hit the United States of America. I asked God, why did you not turn this? Why did you allow this storm to turn? It tore the Bahamas all to pieces. I know your voice, Lord. The voice of a stranger, I won't follow it. But Lord, the storm turned. But Lord, I heard the Spirit of the Lord tell me, he said, my grace is sufficient. He say, the prayers of the righteous avail much. I have a lot of righteous people in the United States. I ain't trying to make no apologies. Thus said the Lord. Thus said the Lord. I prophesied what I heard God say. But the storm turned. It destroyed the Bahamas, tore it all to pieces. Category 5. But God told me to tell the people that the year 2019 is not over with yet. You're still, there's still storms coming off the coast of Africa. Right now.
Right.
Woe unto the children of the living God. Woe unto the church of the living God. Woe unto that church. That light is dim. I pray that God's fire will be rekindled in you. When everything is going right, don't nobody want to leave the party. But when they start cutting the lights off, they blinking the lights, they tell you the party's getting ready to be over. The lights are blinking, America. God is flashing the lights. The party's fitting to be open. Bread everywhere. I can take you to Houston, Texas right now. Behind the bread house, they got bread in the dumpsters. Full of bread. Or when the bread starts drying up. When the eagle gets ready to teach our little young ones how to fly. In the nest. She built the nest out of sticks, thorns, and whatever she could get the feathers to make the nest soft for the little chicklets. But when it's time for them, they big enough to learn how to get out the nest, now she wants to teach them to fly. The church of the living God. God is going to start, he's beginning to pluck the cushion out of the nest. America, my country, tis of thee, my land of liberty. It's always been good in America, ever since I was born. Even though I grew up a black man in America, I've seen injustice. I've seen certain things happen in America that wasn't fair, but that's okay. Love is the key. God still showed his love and his grace and his mercy. Get ready, America. It's coming. It's coming. It's going to come a time that we're going to cry to go home. Lord, come get me. I'm ready to go home. Because it's bad down here.
Yeah.
See, as long as it's good, don't nobody want to leave.
Man.
But boy, when he starts blinking the lights, the party's getting ready to be over. Church,
yeah,
of the living God, the,
yeah,
party's getting ready to be over. All this pride. All you preachers that got all that pride, walk around like a peacock, Boy, when the river start drying up, and ain't no water to drink, what you gonna do then? Send a man. Talking to the church though. Where you gonna run in that day? Huh? You gonna wanna get out of here then? Huh? You gonna wanna get up out of here? It's coming. Socialism, communism, one world government, one world organization, one church, one ruler. That's what it's going to. You trust in your guns, America. You believe in your AR-47s, your whatever. You believe in your weapons right now. In every house, they got guns. But the government gonna take your guns away. Then what you gonna trust in? Who you gonna trust? Who you gonna run to? Your gun? Gun ain't gonna save you because they gonna take them. They know right now they can't take control because there are too many guns in America. Even the church, they passed a law in Texas. You can take your gun to church in the state of Texas. You don't have to take the Holy Ghost, but you can take your gun. Live by the sword. You live by the sword, you do what? You die by the sword. That's why we need the greater one inside of us. Everything we need the Holy Ghost to protect us. When Israel came up against the Red Sea, Pharaoh was coming. Get him back. The Red Sea was in the front of him. Moses got all these people out in the middle of the desert. They know Pharaoh gonna whoop their butts and kill them when he catch up with them. Because I didn't tell y'all to leave. I'm gonna kill y'all. But God let the fire fall between them and Pharaoh. Lord, I pray that you would send your holy fire right now.
Amen.
I pray that your fire would fall on the United States of America to separate the church, the true church, from the world. There's got to be a difference between the real church and the world. I'm talking about church, I'm talking about tabernacles, human beings that are filled with the Spirit of God. Let there be a difference between them and the people that live in the world.
Yes.
Father, I pray your strength right now in your people. I pray for your army, because God has an army, soldiers of the living God. Mm. And I pray their strength right now in you, Father, in the name of Jesus, because it's gonna get darker and darker and darker and darker. The party's getting ready to be over, church.
Yes.
But there's a big party gonna be taking place in heaven.
Yes.
And that's where I wanna be. I wanna be at that great party in the sky. Yes. I wanna be singing, dancing, and shouting around his throne. Yes, sir, on that day. When he called my name, Dixon, I'm out of here. I'm out of here. And I pray that my soul stay anchored in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And I pray for your strength today in the Lord.
Yes.
Come to Jesus while there's time, church.
Amen.
Yes.
Come to Jesus while there's time.
Yes, Lord.
Yes.
Come to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
While there's time. Come to Jesus while there's time.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
You gave me four words.
Four words.
Four words, y'all.
Mm-hmm.
He said, visiting. It's done.
It's done.
Home.
Uh-huh.
Visiting.
Praise God.
What's that now? Come again.
Visiting.
Uh-huh.
Done. It's done.
It's done.
Home.
Home. It's done. Home. Four words.
You know what?
Work is finished.
He was young. He was a young man.
Young man.
Jesus was a young man.
So yes, he was.
What Jesus said on the cross?
It's finished.
It's finished.
It's finished.
It's
finished.
Done.
It's
done.
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 Done. Done. Ran his race.
We all here just visiting.
We just
visiting. It's not our home.
Come on. Come on, Mr. Caldwell.
But the last word he told it, home.
Home.
Now he's home.
He's home.
He's here just visiting, y'all.
Visiting.
We all here just visiting.
We all just visiting.
We all going home one day.
One day.
That's why we're here every Sunday.
Every Sunday.
So we can go home.
That's good.
That's good. Look around into Last Call Ministries. Baba, we ask that you would increase it right now. Increase into their pocketbook. Increase into their bank account. Lord, let money, supernatural money, show up at their doorstep, Father. Cause some man or woman to give into their bosom, Father. In the name of Jesus, we pray. And Father, we say thank you right now. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. In the name of Jesus, thank you for this service, Father God. Holy Spirit, we thank you for coming in and moving amongst your people. We thank you for the word that my wife brought today.
Yes.
Thank you. thank you, Father God, that this word will not fall on death ground, Father, on barren ground, but it'll fall in fertile ground, Father God. Everybody that heard it, Father, all over the world, Lord, let it bring increase, Father God, supernatural increase, a great harvest, Lord, unto your kingdom. We thank you right now.
Thank you,
Father God. Lord, be glorified.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, I thank you. I hope you were happy with what we did today for you, Lord.
Because,
Lord, I'm truly happy that you came and showed up today.
Yes,
in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, we just want to thank you. Now, when we leave here, Father, go with us, Father.
Yes.
Protect us and keep us safe.
Yes,
Lord, and bring us back on next Sunday if it be your will, Father.
Yes,
in
Lord.
Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
And let's go,
Y'all ready?
Y'all ready?
Yeah.
Happy birthday,
birthday to y'all. Happy birthday to y'all. Happy birthday, Clarence and Trey and Ellen. Happy birthday to you.
You can put it on and it shoots it out. It goes. Whoop you. You like it?
Yeah.
Thank you so much for watching my awesome mama, evangelist, teacher, Naomi Dixon. Boy, she dove into that word. Like, it just hit me, especially when she's talking about the Holy Spirit and just how we forget about him so many times. And we're in the dispensation of the Holy Spirit, so we must not put him on the shelf. So my mom brought that word to me. She's the best Bible teacher in the world. So we had a great time celebrating my brother's birthday, my nephew Trey's birthday, and Ellie Dog's birthday. We had a great lunch. We had a great cake. I just love my church, and I honor Prophet Dixon, my father, for being our leader. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure you leave a comment, subscribe for more videos. If you have any prayer requests, you can email us at stacysherelle@gmail.com. All right, talk to you later. Bye.